Praise the Lord, saints.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord.
Amen. We thank and praise God for allowing us to be in the house on this morning. We come to you this morning with prayer and scripture, but we're going to do our scripture first. So if you would, please stand for the reading of the word. We'll be coming out of Psalms 37, starting at the first verse. It says, "Fret not thyself because of evil doers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity. For they shall soon be cut down like the grass, and wither as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land, and there thou shalt be fed. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee
bless God for all the leaders. I'm blessed. I'm blessed to know them, to be affiliated with them. And I am so grateful to call them my spiritual parents. Amen. I did get a text from Bishop this morning just letting me know that how much he has enjoyed his birthday. Amen. God is such a good and awesome God. And I have to let you know there's nothing that has happened to me that God, anything good happened to me. And some of the things I might didn't want to happen, but God was still in it. Because he promised to make even those things that are bad work for our good. Because he said, Adam, we know. We know this. Sometimes you have to remind yourself, you know this, that all things are going to work together for your good. Why would they work together? Because you love the Lord, and it is according to his purpose. So some things we go through may not be a blessing, but some are a lesson to get us to a position and a place where God is trying to position us. So if it did not bless you, down the line you will find out, if I had not gone through that, I would not be where I am now. So it's working for your good. It's working. It may not always feel good. It may not always work or be good. But I'm glad to know that it is working for my good. So when we look at my subject today and we talk about dedicated prayer life, we talk about being devoted to it. We're talking about honoring it. Oh my God, as if you had made a promise and became man and wife, you promised her to love her, to love him only to yourself. When it comes to the word of God, you should be more dedicated to it as well as your spouse. But we thank God to know that when you are dedicated and when you are devoted, nothing can pull you from it. You already know what you're going to do and when you're going to do it. And when you are relentless, it means that you will not stop. Oh God, you are determined to push forward. I don't know who I'm speaking to today, but God wanted me to talk about being dedicated to your prayer life. Anybody in here got a prayer life? Do you talk to God in the morning? Do you talk to him at the afternoon? Have you been talking to him while you're sitting here? God has an expectancy from us to believe him when it comes to his people. We want to ask him for things, but only when we get in trouble. But I'm glad to know this morning that we do not have to wait until we get to trouble. We have an invitation that we can go to the throne of grace. Hallelujah. We can make our petition known unto God. I am reminded of his word that to be careful for nothing, but in all things give prayer and supplication unto the Lord. And therefore, we don't have to worry. We don't have to fret. We don't have to get upset, because we have got to have the confidence. Hallelujah. 1 John 5:14 says, this is the confidence that we have in him, that we ask anything according to his will, that he will do it. As 16 says, if we know that we got it, we already got what we ask him for, as long as it is in his will. Now, I have to admit some things. There are some times that I have been guilty of some things. To pray, but you got so distracted, and now your body is tired. All you want to do is sleep. So you tell God, okay, God, I'll wake up and speak to you later. You have to be reminded, just as if the spirit is pushing you to pray, there is another spirit that's supposed to stop you from praying, because everything we do has to be by prayer and supplication. And we have to talk to God. Now, we have to be reminded that we can have faith sometimes in our mother's prayer. We can have faith in Bishop's prayer. But honey, what about your prayer? What if you can't get to Bishop? What if you can't get to Mother? What are you going to do? You got to have a relationship with God yourself so you can know when you need to pray. Wait till something happen and then pray. We should already have sown up that sown before my accident and before we get on the special about him, but he believed God and he was a man of God. And the Bible said that Elijah prayed that the heavens would not produce rain. Do you not know what your prayer can do? Your prayer can change the hearts of kings. Your prayer can stop wars. Are y'all aware that you have a power down in you to speak a word? That God will honor your word. I heard it when he said over in the book of Psalms that your power of life and death, Proverbs, the power of life and death is in your tongue. You can speak it over you. You can speak it over your life. When your body is aching with pain, you just remind your body that it's healed in the name of Jesus. When you're going through hard times, you got to remind yourself that this too shall pass. That it won't always be like this. Hallelujah. That God will change things. He will turn things. Have y'all ever had to turn things around? You went to court for one thing, and you thought it was just that bad. But when you got off your knees, God has already told you, I've got it handled on me. I got this one. This battle is not yours. I'm gonna handle this. We have to know, y'all, what we got. The enemy does not want us to know that the weapon of our warfare, that they are not common. But God, here God said they are mighty. They are mighty weapons. Hallelujah. You think Russia got some weapons. You think the United States got some weapons. Baby, we got something bigger than an atomic bomb. We got something bigger and more powerful. Because we've got the name of God. So therefore, we don't have to worry what come or what may. Because we So Elijah prayed. I'm almost through, I promise y'all. So Elijah prayed that God would shut up heaven. And the Bible says for 3.5 years, there was no rain. There was no dew. Have you ever prayed that God shut up a mouth that keeps up a hollering sentence against you? Have y'all ever took that authority? I'm taking it, hallelujah. That when they tried to call and say negativity against me, we have that power. We have that power. And after 3.5 years, Elijah went back after he had told King Ahab he gonna shut it up. He went back and told King Ahab, it's gonna rain now. And Ahab thought he's crazy. But I hear when Elijah began to get in a posture of prayer. Hallelujah. There's different postures that you can put your body in to pray. And so the Bible says that he sat down and put his head between his legs and began to pray unto our God. And after he prayed, he told his servant, go up and see. Go up and tell me, what do you see? And he saw nothing at first. And when he saw nothing, Elijah began to pray more. Because it does not happen the first time does not mean you should give up. He's gonna find it. And to anyone that's knocking on, pray. Somehow the enemy will tell you, our God know he a sinner. I beg to differ. That was the people said that in John 9. God didn't say that. Go look at it again. It ain't red. If it ain't red, God didn't say it. We realize that everything in the Bible is of the word of God. But everything in the Bible, some of it is just history. Things we need to know. But God heard this sinner's prayer. Did you not pray for your salvation? Did you not ask God to fill you? We'll be right back. Thank you. Minister to y'all this morning. And I'm grateful for the sacredness. God is
People of God, sometimes God wakes me up. You know, you're gonna be sleepy, tired. I look at the clock, it's 3:00 in the morning. And God wakes me up at that time because there's no distraction. I either go in the bathroom or stay in and pray, or go in the living room or whatever, or stay in the bed and pray. But it's for a reason. The enemy is attacking at night while you sleep. He's on the attack. He's on the prowl. So we have to pray without ceasing at all times, all times, over our children, over our grandchildren, over our family. Our pastor, first lady, we got to pray things. And we thank God for you, Minister Watson, for that word. Relentless prayer line. Let's give the Lord another hand, pray for her, and ask Deacon Dave to come up.
Do announcements first.
Lady Charlotte Jones and the Daughters of Zion present Noonday Tea in Paris 2024. Ooh la la! May 4th at 12 p.m. at the ALC Church Courtyard. The price is $40 per person, and it's Minister Pamela Bunn, Sister Marie May, Minister Michelle Stella, Sister Jessica Glover, or Sister Katrina Harrell for tickets. And ladies, the deadline to order is April 26th. They're available in different colors and styles. Get yours today. Soldiers of the Cross Church, Pastor Danita Ryan presents Men's Choir, Thank God's Workmanship. Sunday, May 5th at 4 p.m., guest speaker will be our very own Bishop Terry A. Jones. Be our guest, Greater Grace Church, Family and Friends Day, Sunday, May 19th. This day is Youth Sunday, so dress casual. We will also be celebrating Lupus Awareness Month, so wear purple. And we will also celebrate our graduates of Greater Grace. Lunch will be served after service.
Greater Grace campaign for parks. Donate today to help us raise $10,000 to replace the park in our family. Come on, y'all, we can do it. Everybody do their part.
Attention all Greater Grace graduates. Please turn your names, school, and grade being promoted to, grade promoted to, or future aspirations, and a picture by April 30th to myself or Sister Kayla. We will celebrate May 19th. This is limited to members of children and or grandchildren of members. Thank you. Have a blessed day. Happy birthday to all members born in April. Salia Williams, Jacob Brown, Kenny Garrett, Emory Bowles, Ashley Costella, and our illustrious Bishop Terry A. Jones, and our lovely Lady Charlotte Jones. Happy birthday to all. Happy birthday to our awesome leader, the illustrious Bishop Terry A. Jones on the 12th, and our gorgeous and sweet Lady Charlotte Jones on the 13th. To bless them, you can cash out $LadyCJones, or you can see Sister Renee Bird before Sunday. Thank you in advance. Greater Grace Church now has a community. Anybody interested in donating or receiving a donation, please contact someone on the outreach ministry. Thank you in advance.
To receive church reminders, please send a text to 81010 with this message at MINMI.
Join us every Monday for intercessory prayer at 12 p.m. With the announcements are as follows: Sunday school 8 a.m., Sunday morning worship 9 a.m., youth studies every Sunday at 7 p.m., Bible study every Wednesday night at 5:30, youth dance rehearsal every Wednesday night at 6 p.m., choir rehearsal every Wednesday at 6:30, praise team rehearsal every Wednesday at 7:15 p.m., intertwined marriage ministry every second Tuesday of the month at 6 p.m. If you have any announcements, please give them to Elder Karen Williams, Minister Jerry Bugs, or myself, Minister Michelle Stella. Ways to sow. Cash App, $GreaterGraceAshton. PayPal and Zelle, GreaterGrace977@gmail.com. We also now have Apple Pay and Zelle Card Reader. To bless Bishop and Lady personally, you can cash at them at $LadyCJones. Asking all members to please create an account on the new Church Track Connect page as soon as you can. This page is your direct access to the administrative staff, your giving statements, and any church announcement information you may need. If you need any help accessing this site, please see Minister Michelle Mastella. Thanks in advance for your cooperation. These are your Greater Grace Church announcements.
Praise the Lord, everyone. I have a couple more announcements. We received this morning from Deliverance Church of Philadelphia. There will be praise in the park. Yeah, this is awesome. In Asheville. I think this is the first time that they're doing this event, but they're asking all the local churches and the community to join together to let this event be a success. It will be June 8, 2024, and they're asking every church in Asheville for their praise team, youth choir, soloists, instruments, musicians, praise team, praise dance teams, and anyone that wants to sing or whatever to participate in this program. Please see Sister Benita Williams if you're interested in participating. We plan to be there, so you guys come and help us lift up the name of the Lord. Let's give a hand and pray for that. And also, we have the praise team. We have tickets for sale. We're having a benefit for Sister Tammy. We're selling tickets to receive. We have several people that supported us in gift cards. So we have like 5, 6, 7, 8 gift cards, I think, to give away. The tickets are $5 each, or you can get 5 tickets for $20. But this is to go towards her to help replace some of the items that she lost. You know, some things are irreplaceable. You can't put a price on some things that are that we are connected to. So we just want to bless her. And like I said, some of the gift cards are for Jumbo's and Pale City Restaurant. We have gift cards to Sugar Sweets Bakery in Pale City. Just all kind of gift cards. $50 gift card to Twice Blessed Consignment. So if you want to help bless Sister Tammy, you can do that. And also the youth will be selling candy apples out front. So they are $5. Get your candy apples today. Sister, we love our sister right there. Sister Odie, they blessed us with, Demetra blessed us with the candy apple. Y'all know she can cook like her mama. So yeah, get your candy apples today. I know my sugar gonna be high. I'm gonna take a little extra insulin, but I'm getting me one. Okay, God be blessed. And Ben's gonna do good. Brother Deacon Dave, I'm sorry.
Well, let's keep these announcements in mind. It's time for our offering. Everyone can play a part in this. We want to be a cheerful giver. We want to ask our brethren to come up to take up our offering. And you know, God loves a cheerful giver. We can't be God giving. You know, he said in his word, you know, we give in Malachi, and we give. He shall give it back unto us, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall me and give them to our bosom. So we know that we can't be God's giving. So when we give, we're going to give expecting a return. Amen. So we're going to ask everyone to stand as we go before the throne of grace. Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for our pastor and our leaders, Lord. We just say thank you for the many blessings, Lord, that you have stored upon us, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for this offering, Lord. Let it be used for the upbuilding of thy kingdom, Lord. And Lord, we know that you is the only blesser right now. Lord, we know that you can give it back. Good measure. Press down and shaking together and running over. Shall be and give it back unto our bosom, Lord. And Lord, we just said thank you for the many blessings, Lord. And Lord, we ask that these blessings In your son Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen. I'm going to ask everyone to come from the rear. Give according to.
And everybody, we have one more announcement. We start. Let's give the Lord a hand. Praise the sister Darlene for the birthday decoration she did by Bishop and First Lady in the lobby. And we're asking everyone to stop by and do a short birthday video to wish our pastor and first lady a happy birthday, and it's gonna be sent to them, and they'll know how much you appreciate them.
You are dismissed.